scope of questions posed.
At 3:03 of the first period, Luke Robitaille showed his hometown fans
first
what
shot, great save here
on the
deflection by Watt.
Power play goal.
And Luke Robitaille just banks it off the
in straight time. Now John LeClaire. LeClaire from Montreal. Passing left side. Moving in. And Ronan in front. Score! It went off Gretzky, I believe. The game is tied.
Good thing was I really fired it, too. It wasn't an easy shot. It was probably a harder shot than the one I scored, but. You know, we played a very good game tonight, and other than the one I tipped in, Kelly probably would have shut out.
Once again, Kelly Rudy was magnificent, stopping everything the Habs set at him, even when on the power play. He turned away 30 of 31 shots on goal. The Kings outshot Montreal 20-10 in the second, 38-31 overall. One of those Kings shots was the eighth playoff goal by none other than Luke Robitaille.
Robitaille playing at home before the home folks. There's a smile on your face.
Well, he was great tonight. Lucky's been much maligned this series, and I don't think fairly. People say if Lucky's not scoring, he's not helping the club, and that's totally wrong. Now he's given us a lot of other things, but I was very happy. He's so keyed up right now, so excited about playing here. He's the only kid we have from Quebec, and this building means a lot to him. It doesn't mean much to any of the rest of us, but it means an awful lot to him, and you saw what he did tonight.
The Kings made it 3-1. Los Angeles in the first 2 minutes of the third period. That's when Yari Curry registered his ninth goal of the playoffs. And Gretzky's empty netter in the final 2 minutes of the game was icing on a very special Kings cake. The Kings win it 4-1, and since 1939, the team who has won game one of the Stanley Cup Finals has won the Cup 81.5% of the time.
The Toronto series is physical and it was very emotional. To win a game seven there and then come into Montreal 4-1, first game of the finals and play the way we did, I'm pretty proud of our hockey club. But it's only one game, we got to win three more and our work will get harder next game.
Your thoughts on this first game?
Well, again, I think we're a different team than they've seen the last three games. I don't think they've seen an aggressive team. You know, they caught the Islanders after beating Pittsburgh. That was basically their Stanley Cup. And the same thing with Buffalo. When Buffalo beat Boston, that was basically their Stanley Cup. So they've caught a team that's very focused now, a little bit different than they're used to. But we know Montreal will be back next game. They 8 days off hurt them. And we'll have to be better than ever to beat them next game.
Thank you so much. Barry Melrose, head coach of the Kings, who beat the Montreal Canadiens tonight by a score of 4-1. They've got the home ice advantage, but there's still game two and many others to be played. From the Forum here in Montreal, I'm Stu Nahan for Channel 5 News at 10.
Assume that the backward motion of the pad of Kelly Rudy, now the puck is right against his pad. Adam Kearns gives it to Semenov. Semenov, his shot, score! You look at it again. He'll come into the right of your screen. There, Reichel gets his stick on it to tip it in. And he's been in front all night, and he hasn't given up on the play. Here's the deflection. It goes off. Good bounce for the Kings once on the stick. Very quickly, he doesn't stop the puck. Watch it. And that quickness, right there, little chip shot. It beats Kirk McLean. McLean, he tries it. I think he's going to get his own rebound back. Watch the puck slide all the way through. Yep, it's right back onto the...
of his playoff career, and the Kings lead 5-2.
The first goal here in the third period by Luke Robitaille has turned it around for the Kings. Gretzky tries the pass. There's a milestone for you. 100 career playoff goals. That leads the NHL in its history. Another look. His directions on the way in. Nice draw there on the forehand. I think it hit Luke Robitaille, the Kings, the closest man to
cup it up right there. And Rudy with a big save. Here's Donnelly on a break. Donnelly could tie it. He shoots. He scores. Left side. Here's Donnelly with Curry. Donnelly shoots. Score! Kings win in overtime. Donnelly ties the game and then wins it in overtime. 4-3 Kings.
The Kings are still alive. They get a big win here in overtime. Mike Donnelly blasting it. The Oilers had a chance in the neutral zone to stop the attack. One of the Oilers waved at it. Helpless feeling out there. You see a forward trying to get him the stick. McSorley puts Mahler into the back of the net, then pushes, keeps pushing. And then he backs, even to watch Kirk Muller's right between the legs, and Kirk Muller was trying that play all the way. 15 seconds to go in the power play. Pass to the right side, up the middle now to Keane. He shoots wide. Rebound shot, score! The rebound came right off the... Gets help from Donnelly. With the puck taken away by the Canadians, but held in by Granato to Donnelly. Save wall, rebound, score! Mike Donnelly, Ellenstrom. Sandstrom in front, Gretzky. Gretzky behind the net. Gretzky to McSorley. He scores! Pedro, left side, shoot, save Rudy. Rebound, knocked into the corner. Loose puck, DiPietro shoots, save Rudy.
Canadians, Luke Robitaille with the first shot. And the puck is loose for a split second. But Patrick Waugh gets...
Oh, he shoots, save Kelly Rudy on a hard shot by DiPietro. DiPietro again, shoots, save Rudy. Rebound, Kings with it. 3-on-2, up the center. Donnelly, Millen, Granato. Donnelly to Granato, shoots, save. Rebound zone, game tied at 2. Puck comes into the corner. Carson didn't get it. Now Granato in front. Shoots. Save. McSorley can't get a shot.
Now Kelly Rudy goes with his fake. Stays with LeClaire all the way. Watch Rudy. Good positioning. Then there's just a little bit of room. A very strong man comes out in front. Banks it off. The Kings defenseman.
No. Overtime. John LeClaire jammed it past the left goalpost. And Montreal has won their 10th straight overtime game this year, and they lead the series 3-1.
Montreal taking advantage of a long ring around the boards. It might have been a shot by the Kings that came all the way around. And Jean LeClaire,
Warren Weeb.
Bellows works hard, and as soon as the defenseman reads it, as soon as he can feel it, there's Bellows. It hits his stick and drops between the... Look at it. LeBeau here. Here's the crisscross. This changes things from a 3-on-3 to allow Keane to get some time. Yes, it's deflected. Gilbert in play, but the defenseman drives hard. You wouldn't see this from the Montreal Canadiens a year ago. There's Snyder, Thomas Sandstrom all over him, but you have that stick.
Yeah.
He goes one way, the pass comes out the other. Waugh still can't find the puck. Then he can't find it because of the screen of Thomas.
And the loose puck, Granato with it. Montreal zone. Right wing, he shoots, he scores!
By the Kings, left of your screen, you see Thomas Sandstrom there just interfering. Gretzky likes to go right to left. He's moving left there, shoots back against the flow, gets a deflection. Lyle Odelein, here's McSorley. Punching the puck through, Odelein right here, grabs onto the stick of Marty McSorley. Oh. McSorley goes down.
And here's the shot by Bellows, deflected. Muller in front of LeClaire, he shoots, save, rebound. LeClaire again, shoots, knocked down. LeClaire again, he scores! Montreal wins! John LeClaire had 3 chances. And the third one he put in, and Montreal wins 4-3. And they lead the series 2-1. They've won 9 straight in overtime. So a great Kings comeback is negated by an overtime goal. John LeClaire had 3 weapons.
Tanya's feelings are...